Hello there, and welcome to Everything Coptic. And today, as we approach this Feast of Theophany, I want to speak about the Coptic culture and feasting, and what it means for us and how we should be transformed. Now, I would be afraid to say that the current culture is surrounded by the food. And what does that mean? That the food is the center, and everything else surrounds that food, that meal, breaking our fast. So, for example, we'll spend the whole entire day preparing for the food, and the whole entire day craving the food. And then when it comes to the feast, well, this is a precursor to having the meal, but if I need to stay home and prepare the food, that's fine. Or if I need to leave early to go enjoy the food, that's fine. Or rather, I hope the service is quick so I can enjoy the food. And then there are other things. There's picture taking, and there's all the festivities of seeing friends and whatever it is. But it doesn't seem that a god is the center of the feast. So then what happens is when we have a feast that's perhaps like our last nativity feast. It was on a Sunday night. The next day there's work, there's school. And it was raining, so the churches were empty, because the focus of the feast was not God. And when we notice in our lives that the focus of our lives is not God, it seems to be that the things pertaining to God just seem to leak from the cracks. We no longer care about them because there's so many other things. So for example, I have an exam, I have tests, I have homework, I have other things, I have stuff I need to study, therefore I cannot go to the feast. Well, how does God feel when he thinks that he gives his only son to die for us so that we can have eternal life, so that we could study and we can miss his feasts? We can miss his baptism day or his birthday or the other feasts for his son. And I don't think God gave us his son to die so that we could do homework or that we could go to work, or that we could do whatever it is, prepare the meal. God gave us his son so that we could have life and have life in him and can share with him. And more so, so that he could be among us, that we could worship him and glorify him. So if we are not spending that feast worshiping God, glorifying him, if the feast does not revolve around God, if something else has penetrated that center, then we've come to a culture that has lost God. We need to be a God-centric culture where he is the center, where we have preparation for the feast and where that preparation matters, and where we consider, well, you know, there's the feast, but there is work. Okay, then I need to go to the feast, and I will make up for it by either sleeping beforehand or other things. See, when the feast is the center, now suddenly our mindset changes. We're not going to be quick to throw away the feast. We're going to think of alternatives, because I can't miss that feast, just like I can't miss a day of work, just like I can't miss the school assignment. So I pray that tomorrow's Theophany, it's on a Friday night, and the following day, it's a Saturday, this is the actual day of the feast, but we'll be at liturgy Friday night. For most people, there's no work, there's no school the next day. Let's all attend this year. I know many of us did not attend Nativity because of the storms and because of the fact it was on a Sunday night, but there's no excuse for Theophany. Theophany is a great and excellent feast. Let us all celebrate it together, and let us celebrate our Lord Jesus Christ, to whom is due all glory and honor with the good Father and the Holy Spirit, and glory be to God forever. Amen.